It was another interesting day in court. Attorneys actually brought in a mannequin to show jurors how Zimmerman and Trayvon Martin's struggle played out.
Where would the gun be right now in relation to me?
Are the injuries on Mr. Zimmerman's back of his head consistent with someone doing this on cement?
Zimmerman claims he shot Trayvon Martin while the teen straddled and punched him, but we won't hear it from him on the stand.
And what is your decision, sir?
After consulting with counsel, not to testify, Your Honor.
Prosecutors have also asked the judge to allow the jury to consider lesser charges of manslaughter and aggravated assault. We'll know what the judge decides later this morning at a hearing at 9. Florida Attraction Association sent out an email blast earlier this week asking supporters to use social media to reach out to artists who've canceled appearances at the park's annual Bands, Brew, and Barbecue. They say SeaWorld's done a lot of good through conservation and education programs, but protesters want change.
It's not fair to the animal that they have to be taken out of their natural environment just so that we can be able to see them and learn about them.
The really big fish usually kept in small quarters. Doesn't seem right.
The documentary Blackfish stirred up tons of controversy for the park, focusing on trainer Don Branshaw's death in 2010 and the park's treatment of killer whales. So far, 8 acts have canceled, including Cheap Trick, Trisha Yearwood, and Willie Nelson, most citing the movie.
I've already been convinced that this is not, I don't want to play there, and it's the end of the story.
No word yet on whether it's affecting ticket sales.
The plant erupted into a series of violent explosions that some say sounded like bombs going off.
Went out in the backyard and the sky was just lit up red, vibrant red, with a huge plume of smoke.
24 employees were inside the plant at the time, along with more than 53,000 propane tanks.
They were actively cycling those cylinders. They were doing their job. It could have been a lot worse.
Now, OSHA cited Blue Rhino here in Tavares back in 2011 for serious safety violations regarding cleaning procedures. No word if that was a factor in this explosion. The state fire marshal is looking into a cause.
Just minutes ago, I learned that the officer that was shot, 25-year-old Jason Hajek, he just got out of surgery. He was shot in the stomach after trying to pull these guys over for reckless driving.
He did an outstanding job on the radio, giving suspect information, outlining everything, and that's how we were able to get there so quick.
And I have never seen this many police officers in one area. As I was driving here, dozens throwing on bulletproof vests. They are going door to door this morning, blocking every street corner and covering every inch of this neighborhood until they find these men.
Monica, you're getting new information.
Within the past few minutes, we've learned that this was a suicide. We heard from Grant Heston. He's with UCF, and he tells us that the body did have a self-inflicted gunshot wound. But what's interesting about this is that investigators also found an assault rifle and some homemade explosives along with that body. Of course, hundreds of students were evacuated from the dorm just to be safe. Many are now with the student union until investigators really clear the area. But they're also checking out that suspicious package, or what they're calling a suspicious package, at a parking garage nearby. But we're told that they don't think this is a threat. So we're going to continue following this story. We'll update you again in 30 minutes with the latest. For now, reporting live at UCF, Monica Ricks, News Talk, WDBO.
The 10-year-old is at the hospital right now getting treated for dehydration, but overall, dad and daughter are both safe after getting stuck out in the river for hours.
They were heading back in. The weather turned on them. It got windy. The seas got pretty rough out there, probably 2 to 3 foot.
Lenny Salberg with Fish and Wildlife tells me the girl had a life jacket on and both were able to hang on to the capsized boat until they got pushed to shore. This morning, they walked about 5 miles for help before someone spotted them.
Just one big happy reunion.
The 53-year-old father is pretty shaken this morning, but did take time to thank everyone for their search efforts and says he's glad he and his little girl are safe. Details of this case are pretty gruesome. 16-year-old Nicholas Prochet and 18-year-old Jeremy Stewart tried selling Rodriguez and his friend Jesse Davis guns. But investigators say the boys got in over their heads. They were tortured, shot execution style, then their bodies were burned on Katy Way Trail.
They're standing there naked with their hands bound and something covering their face. And whatever t-shirt you got covering is duct taped to their head. And they're not running.
No.
Davis admitted to the murders.
I just shot one of them in the head, and then I shot the other one in the head.
But Rodriguez maintains his innocence. He rejected a plea deal last week that would have gotten him 30 years behind bars. Now he faces life.
It's a News 96.5 Extra.
If you're looking for something festive to do this holiday season, look no further than Universal. The Grinch is back at Islands of Adventure, serving up another season of Grinchmas.
You're a mean one.
Mr. Grinch.
Naturally, I reached out to the mean one for the inside scoop.
I am Roland. Where is he?
Right here.
So excited to talk to you today.
You should be. Let's be honest, I'm pretty awesome.
Well, let's get down to it. Another year, another Grinchmas. What can we look forward to this year?
This guy right here. You get to see me in all of my glory. You can come hang out with me, take some photos. And if you're looking for other things to do, maybe you're into parades, you can come see the Macy's Holiday Parade.
Boring. We're here to see you.
Exactly.
Oh, I love
it. I like you.
What's your favorite part of this holiday?
Stealing it.
And what's your favorite thing to steal?
Anything I can get my hands on. It's all going to be mine.
Well, I hope you have a terrible Christmas.
I hope you have a terrible Christmas. See you later.
Grinchmas is already underway. It runs through January 4th. For News 96.5, I'm Monica.